You know, the biggest question here, number two, is do athletes or do coaches initiate that contact? And I think there's a lot of confusion around this. And nobody really understands what should happen, how it works, because really it's, you know, in a perfect world, coaches would want athletes to all contact them. And in a perfect world for athletes, they'd want all the coaches contacting them. But the reality is it's a two-way street and it has to happen on both sides. So like you were saying about the prom, you know, I've made parallels to recruiting to help families understand it better. So for parents, I often say it's like searching for a job or hiring somebody. And that means like you're like the coach.
Right.
And if you're searching, you're the athlete, you know, looking for a job. And it is very similar to recruiting and how that process works and the concept behind it. And then, you know, for athletes, I like to have some fun and talk about it like dating, which actually everyone can relate to as well. And maybe people can relate to dating the best because, you know, athletes and stuff, even at a younger age, you have this, you know, attraction and stuff. And so you're going through those adolescence and those stages. So I wanted to, you know, go through a fun scenario with you, John, and just run it through as if
okay.
you know, we're dating,
right?
Not me and you, but as if we're talking about dating.
Right.
Okay. So I made a couple notes here because I remember I've talked it out a few times, but let's just say that I'm the athlete and I'm a boy because I am. So this can work either way. And then let's use the coach as the girl, right? And so, you know, if I'm asking a girl out, then I got to wait to see if there's interest, right? So I might ask a girl out in many different ways nowadays, like, and a lot of it's online through text or email or whatever it is. DMing somebody. So I'm, you know, trying to seek interest. Hey, how's it going? I'm trying to have a conversation with someone, basically telling them, you know, I want to get to know you. I'm interested in you. There's something about you that attracted me to you, right? To want to learn more. And then that girl, you know, there's different options she has to give back to me, right? She could completely ignore me. She could tell me she's not interested to have a relationship with me or even get to know me. She could tell me that she's very interested. She could be hesitant as well. And so there's different scenarios or different options that could happen from that results. And from there, I have to be able to react. So if she ignores me, it could be that maybe she didn't even receive my message, right?
Possibly. She
didn't realize. And so if that's the case, I might hit her up again and be like, hey, you know, I sent you a message or I wanted to see if you wanted to go out, you know, for lunch or whatever. And that could happen. And maybe she just missed it. Or maybe she would eventually then tell me, look, you know, I have a boyfriend or I'm not interested. And in that case, okay. I have two options there. Well, if they have a boyfriend, you let them go. But if she doesn't, then, you know, maybe I have to be a little more persistent in certain things. Like, hey, maybe like we have similar interests. Like, I think you might, you know, enjoy hanging out with me and not putting too much pressure on. But you've obviously realized by looking at her that there may be interest. Or it could be like we said, you know, she's very interested and then there's a good opportunity to get to know each other and somewhat interested, then it's your chance to, you know, sell yourself, market yourself, make hoping that there is that connection.
Right.
And so I hope people can get what I'm trying to say here is that is exactly like an athlete going out to a coach and saying, hey, I'm interested in your school because they looked it up. I've maybe seen your team play or whatnot, and I have interest, and I think I have these right stats that can match up. And, you know, coaches are going to have different reactions for different reasons. And then you have to decide which, you know, way you go. If there's no interest, you know, unfortunately, that's not an option. You move on. If there is interest, then you talk to them.
They also might wait. You know, it doesn't mean that they don't have interest, but they could just be waiting for the right time to reach back to you. So it's with the dating situation or also like with recruiting, right? So when a coach shows or when you're showing interest towards a coach, if you don't hear anything back within a couple of days, it doesn't mean they don't have interest. They might have not even checked their email by that time, right?
That's right.
They have specific time slots, you know, they're busy as well. You know, they have their own schedule throughout the week. You know, they might do every Thursday, every Friday, check the emails, and then, you know, go from there. And then they select their specific times that they'll start contacting recruits depending on which grad year as well, right? So
yeah, I mean, like in the parallel to dating, there is not everybody's ready for a relationship right away or to go out. Maybe they just got out of a relationship. Maybe they're busy because of their specific timeline. The same way with recruiting. Maybe the coach isn't ready to start their recruiting for your grad year yet. Maybe they are. Maybe they already have a bunch of prospects and they don't want to put any more on the list.
Right.
Like, so you make good points there. And I'll throw a couple more things out there that I think are important to understand. Is like, you know, you also have to see, you know, what market you have, like demand, right? There is. So let's just say that, you know, I, you know, happen to have, you know, a girl that I'm reaching out to happens to just have a lot of interest from a number of different guys that would love to go out on a date with her. Well, you know, now she's got options. So, you know, she's gonna maybe not give certain people as much love as other people because of the options that she has. And in the recruiting world, you know, if the coach is getting a lot of interest from, you know, the average player, let's say, that can join their team, and you happen to fit to be, you know, the average player that they could recruit, well, then they may spend more of their time trying to get the top athlete and knowing that the other athletes are coming to them. You know, so you just have to jump on that train as well and understand that, you know, they're going to give you time and attention because they need to if they want to recruit players, but they're also going to be initiating more contact with the higher players because those are the ones that aren't initiating contact with them.
Right.
And so that needs to be understood as well, is that, you know, if you're a top prospect, like maybe they're going to come to you and then that's when the coach is initiating. But otherwise, there will be scenarios where you have to initiate. And I think that that is the concept that sometimes is a bitter pill to swallow, is we're always hoping that the coaches, because, you know, that's their job. Like, I remember one time a dad asked me at an event, he said he was really frustrated, how none of these coaches are coming up to my daughter. Like, I thought I'd been watching college basketball and all this stuff, and I see all those people get recruited. It's like you watch those movies, you watch ESPN and stuff, and you see those top athletes and how those coaches are making home visits and scouting them and recruiting them. But again, that's the reality for a smaller group of people. The majority of the way it works is that the athlete is going out to the coach because the coach also has a lot of interest, and you shouldn't wait, right? So John, you always say it's a two-way street, right?
Yeah. I mean, it's a two-way street. So even, you know, referring to online platforms, you know, such as IMRecruitable as well. If you have one of these platforms and you see, you know, interest, coach activity, you know, stuff happening where you see interest from coaches, you have to reach out to those coaches if there's mutual interest. If I have a school showing that they viewed my profile or I fell under one of their searches, you know, I see interest there. Now, that coach might just write down a name or might take down my information from the profile, but again, might wait 2-3 weeks before they actually contact me. They're just setting up their list for, you know, their 2021 fall recruits, let's say.
Right.
But I shouldn't just be sitting here staring at my computer or my profile and be like, okay, so this school liked me, so I'm just going to wait now until they come back, because they're for sure going to come back because they already liked me. It you know, it can work like that, but you have to take initiative as a student athlete. And if there's mutual interest to some of these schools, coaches showing interest, you have to go back to them and let them know, hey, I see you showed interest on my profile. You know, I'm interested in your program as well, your school. You know, can we get on a call? Can I get a little bit more information? And that's how you get the conversation started. And overall, I went through the recruiting process. You went through the recruiting process. Coaches ultimately prefer it when the student athlete shows confidence and, you know, goes after them rather than the other way around.
Yeah, you make a good point. I mean, we're in it all the time because of IMRecruitable, and those are often the things that, John, you're educating a lot of the families on lately, is, you know, my daughter got, you know, a bunch of searches, bunch of profile views, followers, but not a whole lot of coaches, you know, reaching out and saying it's because, yeah, they're making those little jabs, those connections, but you know, they'll reach out when they're ready and you'll get some, but some you have to do on your own. Like if you fall under a search, like you have to also, yeah, say, because there's a lot of athletes out there. I mean, like coaches only have so much time and resources, especially, you know, in the non-revenue sports outside of football and basketball. I mean, it gets pretty difficult when there's hundreds and thousands of athletes out there, and you know, you can't possibly reach out to everyone. So sometimes it does, as I said earlier, become the place where, you know, the coaches just need to receive rather than always initiate, and have to pick who they want to initiate with versus who they're receiving. So like, I want to make that a little bit, probably hammer that home one more time, make clear is that, you know, college coaches, if they're receiving a whole bunch of interest from a bunch of players that can fit in the middle of their roster or do certain things for them, and, you know, why do they need to go out and get 10 more of those type of players when they're already content? They're going to go to try to initiate contact with the players that are not initiating contact with them, right? And that is like super, super important.
Yeah, and you need to stand out as well. So it's like a competition, right? So example, you know, coaches might get on their computer this weekend, you know, they're doing their job, you know, properly, they're doing it a little bit early maybe, but they're looking at 2021 recruits, so for next fall. Okay, right now they might just look, see what 2021s are available, you know, on an online platform, kind of filter whatever they need to, and they might just create their own list of 20 kids. Okay, at least, yeah, you know, they're getting a head start. If you're one of those kids, you should take initiative. If, again, if there's mutual interest, you need to stand out. So don't wait 3 months for the coach to maybe come back to you, or after 3 months say, hey, I noticed, you know, you like, you know, my profile a few months back. It's like you should step in there right away. And that way the coach is probably going to mark you off as, okay, there's mutual interest and they already reached out, you know, so you can kind of climb the ladder. So it's almost like a competition. I'm sure the coach already has, you know, on top of him finding 20 kids, he probably has 50 other kids that are emailing them, yeah, right?
Yeah.
So exactly. Then you end up being in a pool of 100 kids and there's only two spots available. So how are you going to be one of those two? You have to, you know, again, two-way street. You got to stay in communication and, you know, go after it yourself.
Yeah. I think that, like, it's difficult because like you feel like you've worked really hard and that you deserve a spot. But the reality is that there's a lot of competition and there's a lot of kids that feel the same way. Everybody feels that way, right? So like there isn't always enough spots for everybody. So the process also requires you to really be driven and put in the work, right? So
yeah, when I was getting recruited, I almost, like my top three choices, you know, I almost like bug them to a point where if the name Jonathan came out, they're just going to see my face when they close their eyes. It's just like, oh, that's Jonathan. That's the only Jonathan in the world.
You know?
So you got to kind of like promote yourself like that, like you're saying, and kind of, you know, just, you know, go after it, make them realize you're the right recruit to have.
Yeah. And so like, I'll say another thing there that came up is based on that is that some people are scared to write the coaches and scared to pester them to, you know, if I can use that word, I guess. It's like, obviously you don't want to be annoying them, but annoying coaches is like bothering them 24/7.
Right.
There's nothing wrong with being, you know, in front of them and making sure that they are, you know, they know who you are, like you said. And, you know, that doesn't mean that you can't follow up and communicate. You can't wait for them. They get busy. Like we talked
especially about earlier on, you want them to, like you said, you want them to remember you, right? So if they, yeah, like, I know coaches that literally have 100, 200 emails come in a week.
Right.
So if there's a Jonathan, okay, which Jonathan? There's probably like 20 Jonathans that have emailed this coach in the last 2 months. So it's like, you need to, or if it was me, I need to stick out somehow to be like, okay, that's the Jonathan, you know?
Right. So, yeah. Or if you're me, you just type your name and probably going to be one of me.
Yeah.
One of there's actually a double me, by the way. There's a guy in London who's actually a pretty popular actor and stuff who has exactly the same name, spells it the same way, but thank God he's not an athlete. But yeah, stick out, guys. Put your name out there. It's important. You're not going to bother coaches and just use your judgment. Don't hit them up all day, every day, but you know, if you haven't heard, 72 hours, whatever it is, make sure you reach out.